Hi guys, this is Jason here from Nathaniel. In this lesson, I'm going to introduce you to a rather unique or maybe a very, very, very old school way, which probably was used in the classical period, but or maybe a little bit in the 80s era of music, glam rock, things like that, or progressive rock especially, which uses nothing but the circle of fifths, a picture you see very, very often, right? You can literally Google circle of fifths and you can get like a million pictures. You can probably buy a clock of the circle of fifths, and it's like an obsession amongst the music community, right? It's everywhere. So what people don't tend to tell us about the circle of fifths is that it's not just used for scales. It's also very much used for chords and chord progressions, right? So what I find with a lot of music I used to listen to and continue to listen to, a lot of the prog rock stuff, some classical music, some jazz music, some, I would say, more higher information music, where there's a bit more data, a lot more harmony in the music, you'll find that there's a lot of this circle of fifths usage. Yes, we have 2-5-1s, which is a standard jazz cadence. You have so many classical cadences, which pretty much just go in and around that circle. So the demonstration you heard in the intro, let me just play that for you again. This is one side to the coin, so to speak. So if you see, the last chord is C major. The last chord is C major. But I arrived at C major using a lot of what I call, or what we generally call in the music community, as non-diatonic strategies. Chords which are not part of the scale. If you assume you're on the C major scale, well, none of those chords, or very few of those chords, except that G major chord going to C finally, none of them were really part of the scale, right? And similarly, the second demonstration, which I did in the intro video, happened to go in another route. I went, right? So that's the other movement. So basically, using the circle of fifths, you can try and use those chords which move either in a descending clock or with the clock, clockwise or anti-clockwise, to kind of land at a chord which you are finding of interest, or to build the entire chord progression, right? So before we get started, guys, it'll be great if you can subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Hit the bell icon for regular notifications. Last but not least, do consider our Patreon page, which has a lot of subscription options for you. And at the bare minimum, you're going to get all my handwritten notes, which I have pretty much ever done for like the past few years of doing YouTube videos. And that is the platform where we will continue to host all this content. You also can look at workshops with me, which I do weekly. You can also join our music school by doing, you know, any of our courses. All the links are in the description, but now let's get cracking. Fine. So let's use C major chord as the home base for this exercise, okay? C major is C, E, G. Okay? You can even do it as E, G, C or G, C, E. So you have all these options. Now, traditionally, when you play a chord progression, you're going to look at like a C, maybe a G, A minor, F major, or D minor, F major, G. So all of this is what we call as diatonic music, right? Right? Very nice, but a bit maybe overheard, you could say, right? A little overheard, not only in pop music, but in all the stuff you'll hear, in film songs, in country music, in rock music, you hear diatonic chords. And so it should be, I guess, because the diatonic chords convey most of the emotions we want to convey, right? So it's used for a variety of music. So in this tutorial, we are going to look at how you can use the circle of fifths to kind of create very non-diatonic music or non-diatonic chord progressions. So you take the note C, rather you take the chord C, and now you just kind of drift back to C major via the circle of fifths. Now you can drift back. If you imagine C at 12 o'clock in the circle, you can either drift back to it in the counterclockwise direction, or you can drift towards it in the clockwise direction. So if I go in the counterclockwise direction, you would have at the bare minimum a G going to C, which is a very common cadence. We call it the authentic or the perfect cadence, or just in simple words, a 5 going to 1. See that? Very common cadence. But as I drift further from the circle of fifths, further from the immediate neighbors of C, which are G and F, you go this side, right? So you're going to go C, G, D. Okay? But now I'm going to go approaching back to C, and that'll sound like this. D, E, G, E, C. And it's very melodic. If you look at... Right? Or you could make all these as seventh chords. Right, and those are just dominant chords. Dominant chords are nothing but fives of ones. So you could play like a D7th going down. I'm still moving back to C, right? Or in a counter the clock or reverse clock direction. Now you do another dominant going to tonic. So you could even do it directly without the dominant chord. You can go like... build a little melody around those chords. Okay, so we've done D going to G going to C, which is a reverse clockwise motion, right? We can now consider one more journey, which will be C, G, D, A. So that'll be A, D, G, C. Okay, and it's very melodic. If you think about it, you can just use the chord tones of the chord to kind of build your melody or shape your melody. You can go na 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 na. I'm just leading to the next note. Na 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 la da 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 da. And G ta da 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 da. So on. Or you can do it again with or without the dominant seventh resolution. Okay, and then yeah, you can go further. So C, G, D, A, E. E is the next one in the circle of fifths, right? So okay, so you go E, da, A, D, E, G, E, C. One more time. So all of this stuff which we did so far, the E going to A, going to D, going to G, going to C, it's like an elaborate cadence. It's like a long chord progression which eventually resolves back to C major. And all of this happened in the counterclockwise direction of the circle of fifths. Now, if you look at the circle of fifths in the other direction, in the clockwise direction, the normal way, you will build what we call as plagal cadences. Plagal cadences are fours going to ones. What I told you earlier was authentic cadences or perfect cadences, which are fives going to ones. That is E going to the A going to the D going to the G, and finally G going to the C. So G is like the fifth of C, D is like the fifth of G, and so on and so forth. With plagal cadences, it's going to be a four going to one sequence. So let's try and build the plagal movement. So what are C's neighbors? G in this direction and F in the other direction. So if I take F, C, right? Now we've done a lot of lessons on the plagal cadence. Just type plagal cadence, or you can visit our website where we've sort of listed almost all of our YouTube lessons, categorize them really well. So do head over to nathanielschool.com, right? So you go C, is my target and I go F to C. That's the standard plagal cadence, 4 to 1. Amen. A very church kind of sound which we use very often. Now if you expand that cadence, you go, what is the next after F, right? You do the 4 from F. The 4 from F is B flat. So you go B flat, F, and end on C. B flat, F, C. Very Beatles-like, you know? You know the song. B flat, F, C. Okay? But you can expand that. You can go... Eventually, you're coming back to C, but in the other direction of the circle. So what comes after? So C, F, B flat, E flat. So let's just do the reverse. Going back to C, how do I go? E flat, B flat, F, and C. So that'll be... It's almost like its own... It's almost like its own progression right now, right? E flat, B flat, F, C, and let's hint at one more. So after E flat, what's the next one in the descending clock of the circle? C, F, B flat, E flat, A flat. So let's try A flat. A flat going to E flat, B flat going to F, and F descending back to C. It's a very nice sound. B flat, F. Do a little suspended there. Resolve it to major. One more time. A flat. Ba da 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 ba da. E flat. Ba da 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 da. B flat. Ba da da da. F. C. End on C. Okay, while the other progression went E, A, D, G, C, that's E, A, D, G, C, those are all your authentic or perfect cadences, while your plagals were starting from A flat and descending back to C, A flat, E flat, B flat, F, C. Right, so in my first few years of music composition, I thought this was it. I was like, wow, the circle of fifths can do so much. After trying to transcribe a few of my favorite prog songs, progressive rock songs from bands like Dream Theater and the like. Now, what I also discovered a little later in my career was the fact that all of these chords need not be major. They can be minor as well, and they will work really great if you ask me. So if you take that perfect resolution back and forth back to C, maybe it could end with C minor instead of C major. And let's try and see if everything can be minor chords instead. So you do G minor, C minor, G minor, pa 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 pa, G minor, C minor. Then you do going to G, going to C. Let's go one step up. A, A minor. You could even resolve it to major. Or all minors. Okay, or you could do like a bigger jump, which is E minor. E minor, A minor, D minor, G minor, C. Depends on how you weave a melody around those chords, right? And what about the plagal motion, the 4 going to 1? You could do minor 4s going to 1s as well. So you could do like a... F minor going to C minor, F minor, going to C minor, or pa da da di 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 di, which is B flat down the circle to F minor and C minor. One more step. What comes after B flat? E flat. So that's E flat minor. You can build some very interesting motifs there, you know. B flat minor, F minor. Lot more pensive in nature, I guess, right? Also resolve it to C major or C minor. Both options are possible. Again, just the circle of fifths, which most of us musicians stare at every day, right? Yeah, let's go the last direction, last step in the plagal movement, which is A flat. So A flat minor, E flat minor, back to F minor, and then end on C minor or C major, right? So all I wanted to share in this lesson primarily was what the circle of fifths can do in both directions. If you resolve in the counterclockwise direction, you're doing dominant resolutions or perfect cadences or authentic cadences, and that'll be like a 5 going to 1. So if you do endless fives eventually coming to C major, and if you can construct music around that journey, it creates a very, very unique sounding musical chord sequence, right? And if you do the same thing with plagal cadences, you go with the clock and you go all the way again, in this case, back to C. Okay, so just in a nutshell, we did E, A, D, G, C, all fifths. And now if you go in the other direction, you're going to do A flat, E flat, B flat, F, C. Okay, and the goal is to use this and build melodies as well. Obviously, right? You need to play chord progressions with melodies. You can't just leave the chords floating by. So use them and build some nice melodies. And while you're building melodies, if these are too many chords for you, think maybe in terms of two chords at a time. Like if I do the plagal now for you, if I go, okay, the plagal cadence, eventually I'm going to go all those chords. But just here to here, just see what your brain can come up with melodically. Bank that melody and then you can even pattern it. B flat. End on C. The same thing you could do with the other direction. Right, guys? So we've looked at basically the two cadences, the perfect cadences all the way back to the tonic, the home chord, and the plagal cadences back to the home chord. To get cracking with this, I definitely encourage you to write the circle of fifths. Check out our notes on Patreon. The notes will have a PDF of all this stuff, the definitions of everything. And you could start with that. And generally, when you improvise, you could even keep an eye on the chords. Maybe have the circle stuck somewhere or write it in your book and look at that page and so on and so forth. So hope you found this chord progression composition lesson useful. If you haven't already, don't forget to hit that bell, hit the subscribe button. Give the video a like if possible. Leave us a comment for something you'd like to learn, and I will see you in the next one. Cheers.